In this video, we're going to demonstrate how to use ReadSpeaker as a text-to-speech tool in Blackboard. If you are in a Blackboard course or in the Blackboard user interface anywhere, you should see this icon in the very bottom left of your screen. This is the icon that activates the ReadSpeaker service, which will allow you to hear documents and internal text read out loud. To activate that, just simply click the button. You'll see a confirmation of this little icon that appears right here. If you click the play button, it will start playing every piece of text on the screen from the top down. So we recommend using this by actually highlighting the sections of text that you wish to read. For example, I can now highlight this and click listen.
This course contains the resources.
You can see that the text that is being read is highlighted and the active word highlighted in an alternative color. And if you look down on the bottom, you can see play or resume, stop, skip forward or skip backwards. There's an adjustment to volume, playing speed, and of course you can just close the utility. So that is the basics of highlighting text. This works on any text that is in Blackboard, so that might be announcement text, such as we see here. It could also be test text. So if you are taking a quiz and you need or prefer to hear the quiz questions read out loud to you, you can also do that as well. So I'm in a quiz here. I'm just going to highlight my text. Click listen.
Which one of the following planets has no satellite?
So you can get an idea that that works there as well. ReadSpeaker also works in documents that have been uploaded to the course. So you will see that as this little icon here that kind of looks like a speaker next to a page. And if you select that, it's going to open the document in a new window. So you do want to make sure that your pop-ups are allowed. And it's going to open the document reader functionality. Now the document reader has a lot more sophisticated reading controls than just the in-text highlighted version that we were just looking at. You can change the layout, you can look at text mode, which removes any formatting on your page. There are more tools under the More Tools button, such as the Reading Ruler, which can be used like this. Very helpful for keeping your place on a page if you struggle with reading text on a screen. So that's a very useful utility. You can also do things like download an MP3 of the page if you want a complete audio version of the text. We also have general settings. By clicking the settings, you can set your reading speed, you can change your language. The supported languages at COCC we have are English and Spanish. You can also change the text colors, which can be really helpful if the black on white text mode is difficult on your eyes. So you can change these to a variety of different colors and sizes and fonts. One to call out here is the open dyslexic font. So if we save this, this changes it into a font that can be make it easier to read for folks with dyslexia. So that's something to keep in mind as well. The ReadSpeaker document reader should appear again as long as you have activated the ReadSpeaker function, and it should appear next to PDFs. And you can see it has retained our settings in terms of the font choice that we've made. Now, if you log out of Blackboard and you log back in, you'll have to reset these settings, but as long as you are working within one session, it will remember what your choices were. And those are the basics of using ReadSpeaker as a text-to-speech tool in Blackboard.